Hi student, today we're going to have unit 14, digital media. The title implies that we are going to deal with the computer technology and everything related to it. We're going to start with digital. The word digital, it's an adjective. Digital describes information, music, and image, etc., that's recorded or broadcast using computer technology. So digital is an adjective. It describes information, music, an image, etc., that's recorded or broadcast using computer technology. We can describe data as digital, and we can say digital data, a digital recording, a digital camera, digital TV. Digital. Media is a noun. Its verb can be singular or plural. So we can say media is, media are, both are right. What's media? Media is newspapers, magazines, radio, and television considered as a group. So we can describe media as local or national. We can say the local media, the national media. Media attention, media coverage, media reports. An example? The issue has been much discussed in the media. Media. Exclude. It's a verb. It's regular. Can be conjugated regularly. Means not include. An example? He's been excluded from school for bad behavior. Here, it's followed by from as a preposition. He's been excluded from school for bad behavior. Another example, we can say the player was excluded from the team because of injury. Or, women in the past were excluded from social activities. So exclude means not include. More or less means mostly or very nearly. An example, the project was more or less a success. More or less, mostly or very nearly. Rule. A rule is an accepted principle or instruction. So it's an instruction accepted by a group of people. For example, before you start your own business, you should be familiar with the government's rules and regulations. Rule. Stick to. Stick can be conjugated regularly. Can say stuck, second form. Stuck, the third form with the past participle. It must be followed by a noun. Stick means limit yourself to or keep to. For example, stick to the point means keep to the point. Stick to the plan, stick to the rules, stick to a diet, stick to the route, etc. Type as a verb means write using a keyboard. Unpleasant, it's an adjective. It means not enjoyable. We can say unpleasant smell. It's a smell we don't like. An unpleasant man. An unpleasant character. An unpleasant side effect. We can say he was unpleasant with me, or he was unpleasant to me. So, again, we've had digital, media, more or less, rule, stick to, type, unpleasant. Tape script. It's a conversation between Taha and Ahmed. Taha. Hi Ahmed. Could I ask your advice about something? Ahmed, sure. How can I help? Taha. Well, I've just joined an online discussion group and I'm not sure what the rules are. Ahmed, what's the subject of the group? Taha, birds. Ahmed, actually, doesn't really matter what the subject is. If you join any discussion group, the rules are more or less the same. Probably the most important rule is that you must always be polite. You can disagree with other people, but you must not be rude or unpleasant to them. Taha, that's the same as when you're actually with people. If I was with people I didn't know very well, I would never be rude to them. Ahmed, yes, of course. Another rule is that you shouldn't try to advertise or sell things to members of the group. Taha, that's okay. I've got nothing to sell. If I contact the group, I'll only tell people about birds that I've seen or ask them questions about birds. Ahmed, what else? Remember to type carefully and don't write long messages. What language does the group use? Taha, it's an international group, so we use English. Ahmed, another thing to remember is that your messages are public, which means that anyone can read them. Your family, your friends, and even your teacher. Taha, oh yes, I hadn't thought about that. Ahmed, yes, you must be careful not to make anyone upset. And another thing, you should always stick to the subject. Taha, that's okay. I only want to write about birds. Ahmed, there's probably a help page where you can ask other members questions if you aren't sure about anything. And if you write anything that you shouldn't, the owner of the group may email you to remind you about the rules. Taha, I didn't realize that this discussion group had owners. Ahmed, most of them do. It can be quite an important job if it's a busy group and there are a lot of members. Sometimes they exclude people from the group if they break the rules. I'm not sure I want to break any rules, but anyway, thanks a lot. That's really helpful advice. Taha, that's okay. If I had known that you were joining the discussion group, I would have joined too. I love birds, Ahmed. It's not too late. You can join now. As we can see, we have the rules, more or less, unpleasant, unpleasant, exclude, exclude from. Okay. Can you complete these rules for communicating with people online? A. The most important is that you must always be polite. Think. It's the missing word. Yes. It's a rule. So we can say the most important rule is that you must always be polite. B. You can disagree with other people, but you must not be rude or to them. You must be rude or unpleasant to them. Unpleasant. You must not be rude or unpleasant to them. Remember to carefully. Remember to carefully. Remember to type carefully. Type carefully. We have rule, unpleasant, and type. D. You should always the subject. Yes. You should always stick to the subject. E. People won't if you follow the rules. Yes. People won't exclude you if you follow the rules. Now match. Exclude means yes, stop someone going to a place or taking part in something. More or less. Okay, it means about or approximately. Rule. That's right. It's an instruction that says what you can do and you cannot do. Stick to. Yes, not change what you're doing or what you have decided to do. Type, write using a keyboard. Unpleasant, unpleasant, yes, the last one. Describes something that causes unhappiness or discomfort. Reading. young people and technology. If you had asked young people 20 years ago how they spent their free time, they would probably have said that they watched television and videos, listened to music or cassette players, or spent time with their friends. If you ask the same question today, the answers would be very different. Although we still watch television, there are many more channels than there were in the past, and DVDs have replaced videos. We now listen to CDs, but more of us are downloading music and films from the internet. We can listen to or watch these on computers or mobile phones. Of course, we still spend time with our friends, but more of our conversations with them are by text message or through online social networking sites like Facebook and Twitter. These are becoming more popular as ways of communicating with friends and of making new friends. Some people are spending more time chatting to their virtual friends than to their real friends. There is no doubt that modern technology allows us to communicate with many people, many more people than we could in the past. But there are disadvantages. Researchers have found that some people are losing touch with their real friends and becoming addicted to their mobile phones, to their computers, and to social networking sites. If they cannot use their phones and computers, some people become nervous and irritable. And if more people become addicted to their phones, they will find it hard to make real friends. So the question is, can you do without technology? Most people cannot, because technology has become part and parcel of our daily life. Read the meanings of the highlighted words from the article. There are disadvantages. What the meaning of disadvantages? It means bad points. So disadvantages are bad points. More of us are downloading music and films from the internet. But the meaning of downloading, it's moving information from one computer to another via the internet. Downloading means moving information from one computer to another via the internet, through the internet. Some people become nervous and irritable. Irritable here is an adjective. It describes people who are easily annoyed or angry. Irritable means easily annoyed or angry. People who are losing touch with their real friends. Losing touch with. It means no longer speaking or writing to someone. So if you lose touch with someone, you no longer speak or write to them. People are spending more time chatting to their virtual friends. Virtual friends means not real. Virtual means not real. only produced on a computer. So virtual means not real. We have disadvantages, means bad points. Downloading means moving information from one computer to another via the internet. Irritable means easily annoyed or angry. Losing touch with means no longer speaking or writing to someone. Virtual means not real or only produced on a computer. Now, choose the correct words to complete the sentences. A DVD is something you listen to, watch, wear, or play with. A DVD is something you watch. If you are addicted to something, it means you don't like doing it, you have always done it, you can't stop doing it, you want to try it. Now decide. Yes, I have always done it. Because if you are addicted to something, you can't help or you cannot stop yourself from doing it. Addicted. The noun is addiction. Yes. If you chat with someone, you talk to them, eat with them, live with them, make them sad. Chat means talk. Then we'll choose talk to them. The disadvantages of something are its good points, interesting points, things that you don't know, bad points. Yes, bad points. People download pictures and music from. People download pictures and music from the internet. People used to listen to music on. Used to means they no longer do it. Cassette players. An irritable person. An irritable person is a person who is always patient, gets annoyed easily, is always calm, is good at sport, yes, gets annoyed easily. If you lose touch with someone, this means you don't speak or write to them, you forget about them, are in regular contact with them, don't know them. Yes, you don't speak or write to them. Rewrite the abbreviations in brackets in their full forms. My friend's father is an IT expert. IT here is an abbreviation for information technology. Information technology. So IT stands for information technology. My friend's father is an information technology expert and has two PCS, means two personal computers. personal computers. He can watch DVDs. These letters stand for digital, digital, video, or versatile, versatile, or video. Versatile means able to be used for many different purposes. Versatile. And D stands for desk. So DVDs is an abbreviation for digital versatile desk or digital video desk. And we have to add S because it's in the plural form, DVDs. And listen to CDs. CD is an abbreviation for compact discs. Compact on his computer. He often downloads information from the www means World Wide Web, means World Wide Web. IT stands for Information Technology. PSC, personal computers. DVDs, digital versatile desks or digital video desks. CDs, compact desks. WWW is an abbreviation for World Wide Web. Now we have explained our vocab. We'll move on to our grammar lesson, conditionals. We have many types of conditionals. The zero conditional, use the zero conditional to talk about actions that are always true. Example, daily activities and scientific facts. So we can say the zero conditional expresses a habit or a fact. The rule is, if you use if, it can be replaced by when. If, when means every time, it's followed by present simple, present simple. So we can say if present, present. For example, if I feel ill, feel here is the first form of the verb. It's in the present simple tense. If I feel ill, I stay at home. Means every time I feel ill, I stay at home. It's a general habit for me. If we replace he, if we replace I with he, we can say if he, yes, feels ill, he stays at home. So this is the present form. Yes. We use after if or when. Or we can say I stay at home if I feel ill, or he stays at home if he feels ill. So in the zero conditional, when we use if or when means every time. Every time. It's a repeated action. It's called a general habit. Another example. If I stay up late, I choose. I will feel tired the next day. So here I'm talking about a repeated action happening to me. It's considered as a general habit. So if I stay up, stay here with the first form of the verb, it's present. So I have to say I feel, because the next day is not a specific time in the future. I'm talking in general. Every time I stay up late, I feel tired the next day. This is the zero conditional. It expresses either habits or facts. You have to be careful. When dealing with facts, I have to talk in general. We do not speak about any specific people or things. For example, if metals are heated, they expand. Here I'm talking about metals, and metals is in the plural form without any kind of a specification. We cannot say these metals, that's wrong. I cannot say the metals, because we are talking about metals in general. So if metals are heated, they expand. I cannot say they will expand, because we are talking about metals in general. But what if we say if here is another example. If we say, if farmers don't irrigate their land, their plants die, we cannot say will die. Because we are talking about farmers in general. So we cannot say those farmers. That's wrong. Or the farmers. We don't about particular farmers, but we are talking about farmers in general. So we cannot say will die, because every time farmers don't irrigate their land, their plants die. This is the zero conditional. It describes either a fact or a habit, and the form is if present, present. If and when here means every time. Let's move on to the first conditional. Use the first conditional to talk about situation or actions that we think are very possible or probable in the future. So in the first conditional, we are talking about the future. So we can use only if, we cannot use when. It's followed by present simple. And we must change the other sentence and use modals like well, may, can, must, should, have to, any modal verb except yes, except would or could. So we can say the first conditional uses present simple after if and any other modal verb in the other sentence except would or could. Here we are talking about specific people and specific things. If I say, if I hurry, I will catch the bus. This will happen once, only once, in the future. And it's likely for me to catch the bus if I hurry. Hurry is present simple. Will catch, future. So we cannot say, if I hurry, I catch the bus. Because I'm talking about specific bus, talking about myself, only one action that's possible or probable in the future. So I say, I will catch. Will can be replaced with any other modal verb except would or could. So we cannot say would, we cannot say could. Yes, because would and could express actions that are unlikely to happen in the future. So we cannot replace will with would or could. I can say I may catch, I might catch, I can catch, etc. We can say I'll catch the bus if I hurry. If we replace I with he, for example, we have to be careful. Yes. So we will say he hurries, because here we are dealing with the present simple. So if you are talking about the zero conditional, I can say, if I stay up late, I feel tired the next day. But if the next day is replaced by tomorrow, for example, then I'm talking about a particular time in the future. So I have to say, well, feel not, yes, not feel, because it's only one action happening in the future and it's very possible or likely to happen. The second conditional. Use the second conditional to talk about imaginary situations or unlikely situations in the future. So here we are dealing with imaginary situations or unlikely. We use if, it's followed by the second form of the verb, past simple, and we only use would, could, or might. So might can be used in the first conditional or the second conditional. Yes. If we use would or could, this means the action is unlikely to happen in the future. I don't feel ill now. The sentence says, I don't feel. But if I felt, here we use the past simple, the second form of the verb, it expresses that it's unlikely for me to feel ill and I have to follow with I would stay at home. This action is unlikely because I don't feel ill. Here the present is don't feel. The imaginary situation is if I felt. If I don't have, I don't have. If I had. I don't play if I played. So the imaginary action is opposing the present situation, like I don't feel. We can say I would stay at home if I felt ill. Here I have to decide where is the linking word if, and I have to follow it by the second form, if I felt ill. So the second conditional expresses imaginary situations or unlikely situations in the future, and we use the past simple, and we only use would, could, or might followed by the infinitive to express an imaginary or an action which is unlikely to happen in the future. We can also use the second conditional for giving advice, saying if I were you, I'd look for another job. This is my advice to you. So I say, if I were you. So we can use the second conditional to express or to give advice with the form, if I were you, I would look for another job. I would do my best. Yes. Okay. Let's move on to the third conditional. Use the third conditional to talk about past situations or actions that didn't happen. So we are talking about past situations. Past situation. Again, we use the zero conditional to express a habit or a fact. If present, present. And if there means every time. The first conditional expresses an action which is very possible or probable in the future. The form is if present simple and any modal verb except would or could. The second conditional is about imaginary situations or situations which are unlikely to happen in the future. The form is if past simple would, could, or might followed by the infinitive. But the third conditional is about past situations or actions that didn't happen. And the form is we use past perfect after if, and the second sentence should have or should include would, could, or might have and the past participle. So if I say I didn't feel ill yesterday, then I'm talking about yesterday. We are talking about the past. I didn't feel. So if I imagine the situation, it would be if I had felt, but what happened is I didn't feel. So I say if I had felt ill, I would have stayed at home, would have stayed, but I didn't stay at home because I didn't feel ill. So the situation is the opposite. We are talking about a past situation but didn't happen. So this action is impossible. We can say I would have stayed at home if I had felt ill. Now complete these sentences with the correct form of the verbs in brackets. If you join any discussion group, the rules are more or less the same. So we are talking about what kind of conditional? Yes, the zero conditional, because we have are. Are is present. So we say if you join means we put it in the present form. If you join any discussion group, the rules are more or less the same. If I be with people I didn't know very well, I would never be. Would be, would never be. Yes. Okay. It's the second conditional because we have would and it's followed by be, the infinitive. So we have to put be in the right form and say if I was or if I were with people, both are right, but we use where in general when we talk about imaginary situations which are unlikely to happen in the future. We can say I was or I were. Where is more common. If I contacted a group, I only tell people about birds that I've seen. If I contact the group, here we are talking about a specific group. We have that group. So if I contact the group, I will only tell people about birds that I have seen. So I cannot say I only tell people. That's wrong. We have to use well to describe a specific action that's likely to happen in the future. Four, if you write anything you shouldn't, the owner of the group may, yes, we have may, email you to remind you about the rules. So if you, yes, correct, if you write anything you shouldn't, the owner of the group may email you to remind you about the rules. So this is the first conditional. We have may and we have right. It's present simple in the right form. You write. I have to be careful. The verb must agree the subject. You write. Number five. If I had known that you were joining the discussion group, I join too. I love birds. Yes. I had known, past perfect. So it's the third conditional. So we have to put join in the right form and say I, yes, I would have joined, yes, joined. So I use I'd have joined. This means I use would have and the past participle of the verb joined because it's the third conditional. If I had known, this means I didn't know and I didn't join. Now choose. If you lend me your DVD, I would bring or I would bring it back tomorrow. Here we have lend, present. If you lend, that's in the first form. So I have to choose. Will bring, yes, that's right, because we have, yes, also tomorrow. I'm talking about a specific action which is likely to happen tomorrow. If you lend me your DVD, and that's likely to happen, so I will bring it back tomorrow. If Magdi, enough money, I'd buy a new mobile phone. He'd buy a new mobile phone. He would buy. Would buy. Here we have, yes, the second conditional. So I have to use had. I'll ask you a question. Does Magdi have enough money? Does he have enough money? Yes, that's right. No, he doesn't have enough money, so he can't buy a new mobile phone. This is an imaginary action which is unlikely to happen in the future. If Sharif had gone or went to bed earlier last night, here we are talking about last night, it's past. So all past expressions used in the sentence indicate that it's the third conditional. I wouldn't have got, wouldn't have, and the past participle, yes, got. So I have to choose had gone. If Nihal watches frightening films, she doesn't sleep, will not sleep at night. If Nihal watches frightening films, she will not sleep or does not sleep at night. Here we are talking about films, frightening films in general. So it's a habit for Nihal. So when we are talking about habits, we use only present with present. This means every time Nihal watches frightening films, she doesn't sleep at night. It's a repeated habit. You will do well in your exam if you work, or if you will work hard, you will do well in your exam if you. So we have if in the middle of the sentence, so it must be followed by present because we have will here. So we have to choose work because we cannot use well after if. We cannot use well after if. After if, we cannot use well. I would have answered my phone if I had heard it ringing. Here we have if in the middle of the sentence. It's not in the initial position. So I had heard. Past perfect, that's right. So we have to use would have answered. I wouldn't go alone there alone if I had been or were you. So this is advice. If I were you, I wouldn't go there alone. If you leave ice in the sun, it to water very quickly. We are talking about ice in general. We don't refer to specific ice. We only use the word ice. So I'm talking about ice in general. So when we talk about things in general, so it's a fact. If you leave ice in the sun, it, yes, turns. Because every time you leave ice in the sun, it turns to water very quickly. If it hadn't been so hot, hadn't been, yes. It's obvious that it's the third conditional, so I have to use would have played, yes, because we have hadn't been. I'll tell Ali you're looking for him. If I see or saw him, I'll. So it's well if in the middle of the sentence. So it must be followed by present simple, and you have to choose C. If you hadn't warned me, I wouldn't have seen the car coming towards us. The other sentence has wouldn't have seen. So it's a third conditional yes. If you hadn't warned me, I wouldn't have seen the car. So this means you warned me and I saw the car. So this action is imaginary. Yes, it happened in the past. So I say, if you hadn't warned me, but actually you warned me, and as a result, I saw the car coming towards me. You won't or you wouldn't be able to climb so quickly if you take a lot of equipment with you. You be able to climb if you take. Take here is present. You have if, yes, in the middle position. So we have to choose won't. Find and correct the mistakes in the following sentences. One sentence is correct. If I have a headache, have, I'd drink. So it's a combination of present and past. Always indicates that we are talking about a habit, a general habit for me. So I have to use I drink a cup of tea and use the present only I drink. Because if I have a headache means when I have a headache, or every time I have a headache I drink a cup of tea, it always makes me feel better. It's a general habit for me. So we use present. I would come home earlier if I'd known you were worried. We have if in the middle position, and it's followed by had known. Here we are talking about where. Where is past verb. So we are dealing with the third conditional. Had known is right. I have to replace come with would have come, because we are talking about a past experience. We use would have come. If I had known, this means I didn't know, and as a result, I didn't come. If you work hard for the next week, I am sure you'd pass your exam. If you use I'm sure, this means the action is likely to happen. So we use if initially. You work, this is present. Yes, I'm sure you, so we have to replace you'd with you'd pass your exam, because it expresses the first conditional. So it's an action which is likely to happen in the future, and we are talking about next week. If a man knew his friend had no money with him today, he'd have bought him some lunch. I have to decide where is the linking conditional word, if here. is in the initial position of the sentence. It's followed by new, but we are talking about a verb had, so we are talking about past. My friend, his friend had no money. If a man knew his friend had no money, so I have to use had known. Had known, because we have would have bought, would have bought him some lunch in the final sentence. So if Ahmad had known his friend had no money with him today, he'd have bought him some lunch. So if followed by past perfect, because we have had here, then we are talking about past. And when we talk about past experiences, we use the third conditional to express an imaginary action which is impossible to happen. If Omar passed, we have passed after if, his driving test, he'd start saving for a car. This is an abbreviation for would or could. So we are dealing with the second conditional. So this sentence is correct. This is a correct sentence because we have past simple accompanied with would and start the infinitive. Noelle will be at school tomorrow if she felt better. Tomorrow will be at school tomorrow if she felt better. I think the action is likely or possible, so I have to use feels better. We use the present simple. It expresses an action which is likely to happen tomorrow. So Noelle will be at school tomorrow if she feels better. Okay. Dear student, your homework is on pages 159 to 163 and 168 to 171. Good luck.